Mercury does not, and it's because Mercury has a resonance, okay? Mercury feels the gravity of other objects in the solar system, in particular Venus, and when you feel another source of gravity in addition to that of the sun does not succeed in totally tidally locking the planet. There's a tussle between the two objects.
Mercury, the closest planet to the scorching sun, has long been overlooked as a mundane and uninteresting sphere. But appearances can be deceiving. Recent discoveries have shattered our assumptions, revealing a mesmerizing world full of surprises. From hidden reservoirs of water at its poles, to perplexing craters and even unique landforms that are yet to be understood by modern science, Mercury has astounded scientists with its secrets. Despite its small size, Mercury possesses a robust magnetosphere that shields its surface from supernovae, as well as a faint atmosphere that, against all odds, has withstood the test of time. Join us as we unravel the mysterious Mercury and uncover the darkest secrets it holds. Mercury, with a radius of 1,516 miles, resides at an average distance of only 36 million miles from the scorching sun, making it approximately 2.5 times closer to the sun than Earth. Consequently, a year on Mercury lasts a mere 88 days. The temperature on this small planet reaches a scorching 800 degrees Fahrenheit during the day. However, due to its thin atmosphere, the temperature plunges to a bone-chilling negative 290 degrees Fahrenheit at night. Interestingly, Mercury rotates very slowly on its axis, with one day on Mercury equivalent to 59 days on Earth. As a result, day and night cycles on the planet extend for 3 months each. The slow rotation of Mercury is attributed to its unique spin-orbit resonance with the Sun. Previously, it was assumed that tidal forces from the Sun caused this phenomenon. However, research suggests that Mercury has been in a 3-to-2 ratio spin-orbit resonance from its early formation, possibly due to a collision with a massive object that altered its spin rate. Another crucial factor influencing Mercury's rotation and temperature is its eccentric orbit, which resembles the shape of an egg. Depending on its position, Mercury's distance from the Sun can vary between 29 million miles and 43 million miles. In a surprising discovery, scientists found that Mercury's orbit holds a thin, dusty ring around the planet. This finding was unexpected, as Mercury was considered too small and close to the Sun to possess a ring. The origin of this dusty ring is believed to be meteoroids and dust particles clustered in the same orbit as Mercury. This phenomenon may not be exclusive to Mercury, as scientists speculate that similar occurrences might be common in other exoplanet systems. Despite its small size, Mercury boasts a magnetic field. Although it is the smallest in the entire solar system, measuring only 1% of the strength of Earth's magnetic field. This magnetic field creates a magnetosphere, reflecting stellar winds off the surface. However, Mercury's magnetosphere is likely leaky, with openings allowing sunlight to penetrate. The Messenger Space Telescope observed magnetic tornadoes on Mercury's surface, along with magnetic fields carried by the solar wind. These openings in the magnetosphere contribute to replenishing the planet's barely detectable atmosphere. Mercury's magnetic field is generated by the movement of electric current within its liquid metal core. In fact, Mercury's core constitutes 1/3 of the planet's total mass. With a radius of 1,289 miles, the core is approximately half the size of Earth's. Scientists propose that the initial formation processes of the Sun played a role in building up Mercury's large core. During the early stages of planetary formation, when the Sun was surrounded by a protoplanetary disk, the heavy metals concentrated near the Sun. This proximity allowed the metal to accumulate and contribute to the size of Mercury's core. Despite the substantial core, Mercury's proportion of metal silicates remains unusually high compared to other planets. It is speculated that Mercury may have originally been more substantial, but hypothetical cataclysmic events prevented further mass accumulation. For instance, the influence of the formation of Earth and Venus, which could have formed closer to the Sun and then migrated to their current orbits, might have diverted building materials that were meant for Mercury. Now let's talk about Mercury's composition, which has a fascinating backstory. It is possible that the planet's unique makeup is a result of a cosmic collision. Two planets, or a massive space object, could have crashed into Mercury, causing it to lose a significant portion of its outer layer. Such a collision with massive bodies might have thrown Mercury into its current unfavorable orbit, farther from the Sun. These impacts from space objects could have also created the craters we observe on the planet's surface. These are all hypothetical assumptions that await further investigation by upcoming spacecraft missions, like the BepiColombo mission by the European Space Agency and the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency. If you want to know more about this mission, you can watch our detailed video on it. Despite our curiosity to learn more about Mercury, studying it up close is quite challenging. Ground-based telescopes struggle to track it at night due to its proximity to the Sun. Moreover, observing Mercury during the day can damage optics due to the Sun's intense light. Additionally, the planet's small size and the gravitational pull and temperature near the Sun make it difficult to reach. Spacecraft sent to explore Mercury must approach the planet with extreme care, making the journey long and risky. However, despite the challenges, two missions, Mariner 10 and Messenger, have provided us with invaluable knowledge about Mercury. Mariner 10 utilized the gravitational pull of Venus to reach Mercury and captured images, discovered craters, studied the magnetosphere and atmosphere, and measured the planet's temperature. The Messenger spacecraft, 30 years later, became the first to orbit Mercury, providing more comprehensive data. Messenger focused on collecting information about the planet's chemical composition, magnetic field, geological activity, and core. Through these missions, we obtained a wealth of knowledge, including a detailed map of nearly half of Mercury's surface, insights into its geology, and its chemical composition. The spacecraft revealed that Mercury contains oxygen, magnesium, silicon, aluminum, and calcium on its surface. Moreover, the presence of sulfur and water deposits, as well as the shifting magnetic field, offered unexpected discoveries. Messenger's mission lasted approximately 10 years, during which it made numerous intriguing findings. The surface of Mercury exhibits a diverse topography, with a multitude of craters, smooth areas, ridges, and troughs. Over 567 craters have been identified and named after prominent figures. The majority are impact craters caused by collisions with cosmic bodies. These craters can be classified as simple or complex based on their morphology and geological characteristics. Simple craters are more common and smaller, while complex craters are larger and deeper. Interestingly, Mercury has the highest number of such topographic features compared to any other object in the solar system. Additionally, the planet boasts a unique type of crater known as impact basins, which can reach colossal sizes of up to 963 miles in diameter. The abundance of craters on Mercury's surface can be attributed to the planet's lack of a substantial atmosphere and the increasing velocity of objects in solar orbit. One of its most famous basins is Caloris, measuring a staggering 963 miles in diameter, making it Mercury's largest crater. Scientists have discovered that it was once filled with lava, revealing smooth plains at the bottom. Interestingly, The object that created Caloris may have also shaped the chaotic terrain of the planet, characterized by furrows and plains. Another prominent basin, Rembrandt, is about half the size of Caloris and is believed to have undergone similar lava covering in its early stages, resulting in a surrounding smooth area. Mercury boasts various other captivating craters. The oldest known crater on the planet, known as the Basin Thick, is estimated to be over 4 billion years old and is engulfed in darkness, covered by particles ejected from a volcano. Additionally, there are special types of craters on Mercury, including elliptical, polygonal, ghost, and ray craters. Each of these types offers unique insights into the planet's geological activity and age. For instance, elliptical craters, making up only about 2% to 4% of the surface, are formed by low-velocity, large-volume space bodies. The largest elliptical crater, Sven's Daughter, stretches an impressive 137 miles in length. Polygonal craters, characterized by their several angles, are thought to arise due to the structure and dilapidation of Mercury's crust, with approximately 33 of them identified. Ghost craters, barely visible due to lava deposits, exhibit ridges along their edges, formed from the rapid accumulation of lava flows. Lastly, ray craters, observed on both Mercury and the Moon, feature long rays diverging from the crater, indicating the ejection of subsurface elements during impact. These craters play a crucial role in studying Mercury's geological dynamics and age. Younger craters tend to have convex shapes, with terraces on their walls, while older ones appear shallower, potentially filled with volcanic material. Interestingly, NASA researcher Caleb Fassett noticed a lack of craters measuring 12 to 80 miles on Mercury, suggesting the formation of inner crater plains early in the planet's history as a possible explanation. This beckons us to consider: can life overcome the extreme conditions of Mercury and find a way to thrive? Or is its inhospitable environment an insurmountable barrier? Share in comments. Like, subscribe, and watch more content like this here.